BBC Third Programme. Tonight we're relaying from the Royal Opera House Covent Garden a performance of The Bartered Bride by Smetana, to a libretto by Carol Sabina, translated into English by Joan Cross and Eric Crozier. The curtain rises on a lively village scene in Bohemia. It's springtime and the feast day of the patron saint. Everyone is in holiday spirit and enjoying themselves, except Yannick and Majenka, whose romance is threatened because Majenka's parents are seeking a suitable husband for her with the aid of the local marriage broker, Ketzel. Yannick has only recently come to live in the village, and he's poor. Moreover, he refuses to discuss his past life with anyone, but eventually Majenka persuades him to confide in her, and she learns that Yannick's mother died when he was quite young, and that he'd been driven from home by an unkind stepmother. The lovers slip away when they see Majenka's parents approaching in conversation with Ketzel. The bridegroom he has selected for Majenka is the son of a rich farmer named Toby Micha. Ketzel explains that Micha had two sons. The one by his first marriage was a bad character and has disappeared, but that the other one, Vashek, is eminently suitable. Majenka returns and hears their proposition, but rejects it out of hand, saying that she's already given her heart to Yannick. And when Ketzel produces the marriage contract, she knocks the paper out of his hand and stalks angrily away. Her parents suggest that they should discuss the whole matter with Toby Micha and meet his son, while Ketzel says he will try to persuade Yannick to give up the idea of marrying Majenka. The act ends with a polka as the villagers crowd onto the green, dancing and singing. Here now is the cast for Act One in order of singing. Yannick, André Terp. Majenka, Lorna Haywood. Ketzel, the marriage broker, Michael Langdon. Krushina, Majenka's father, Napoleon Bisson. And Ludmila, Majenka's mother, Maureen Guy. With the Covent Garden Chorus, Chorus Master Douglas Robinson, and the Covent Garden Orchestra, led tonight by George Hallam, conducted by Jaroslav Kromhotz. The producer is Hanush Tain. Thank you.
then unluckily father married someone else. It soon became clear how little I was wanted. I had to leave my happy home and spend my childhood days alone and in exile. Oh,
Clear which of the two gets our daughter? nose. Well, what sort of a chap is Vashek? You should have brought him along with you.
For his rich and his handsome, rich and handsome food. set her foot, let's head down to business. Mashenka, now you've agreed. So there is nothing more to do but to sign the deed.
Well, that's a very gloomy
be useful if you could go and find old Toby Misha. Here come all the young folks, soon they will be dancing. Meanwhile, I'll go and look for Yerrick. You leave him to me.
Thank you.
that's the end of Act One of Smetana's opera, The Bartered Bride, broadcast tonight from the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. The introduction to Act Two will begin in just over 15 minutes' time. The BBC Third Program. We're broadcasting now the second act of Smetana's opera, The Bartered Bride, from tonight's performance at the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. Act Two takes place at the village inn, where Ketzel has found Yenik involved in a good-humored argument about the relative merits of drink, love, and money, an argument which is settled by the village girls, who burst in and drag their men out into the green to dance a furiant. Mashenka's prospective husband, Vashek, now makes his first appearance. He's rather slow-witted and has a stammer, more pronounced than usual because his mother has just been telling him it's high time he got married. Mashenka, who has never met Vashek, finds him alone and, realizing who he must be, wastes no time in painting a terrifying picture of his future bride. She tells him that Mashenka has a boyfriend already and is sure to be cruel and unfaithful. She manages to charm Vashek into swearing that he will never marry Mashenka, and her task accomplished, she runs off, followed by her latest admirer. Ketzel returns to the inn with Yenik and tries to convince him that he'd be very unwise to marry Mashenka. Yenik would be far better off with a rich girl. And finally, Ketzel offers him money if he will renounce Mashenka altogether. Yenik jumps to the conclusion that Ketzel wants to marry Mashenka himself, and even when he hears about Vashek, insists on a clause being inserted into the contract to the effect that Mashenka will only marry the son of Toby Micha. Ketzel explains that Micha had two sons, the one by his first marriage was a bad character and has disappeared, but that the other one, Vashek, is eminently suitable. Ketzel calls in the villagers to witness the contract, and there's a chorus of disapproval at the way that Yenik has sold his bride for money. Now here's the cast for Act Two in order of singing. Yenik, Andre Terp. Ketzel, Michael Langdon. Vashek, Kenneth MacDonald. Mashenka, Lorna Haywood. And Krushina, Napoleon Bisson. With the Covent Garden Chorus, Chorus Master Douglas Robinson, and the Covent Garden Orchestra led by George Hallam, conducted by Yaroslav Kromholtz.
way you'll never make. No.
Drink the lousy toast, drink the lousy.
I shall be.
Thank you.
no, not that so, no, 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 not so. If she's like you, if she's like you, then I'd soon say yes.
Thank you.
sir, you must really persevere, sir. How can I see you, sir, I do not wish.
There are more son and in lot, it is true, but some are not. There is one I know quite well, who is a
certainly, let me tell you that the lady has a cozy little
down, sign away your girl.
100 crowns! That's a very good exchange for my Mashenka. I'll never let her go so cheap.
What do you say to 200 then?
Still too little.
Then 300. Better take it quickly. Wait till you've been married a year or two. Then you'll jump at 25. I can't wait for your day to man. I've had enough. Make your mind up now at once. Or you'll find you've lost your bride as well as your money.
Will you tell me who's putting up the money?
I am.
No, you mean for yourself? Oh, you'll not get my girl from me, not for her.
Don't be daft, man. I've no time for girls at my age. I'm a far too old. Worse luck. I'm acting on behalf of my client, the neighbor, my old friend, Tony Mika. Don't waste my time anymore. Take 300 crowns, shake hands, or take them off.
I agree to that. 300 crowns. Let me sign the paper and the whole thing's finished. But on one condition. The only man whom Mashenka's going to wed is the true son of Toby Misha. All the contract will be cancelled on the spot.
What a fuss you're making! It's absolutely clear that the girl will marry Misha's son or nobody.
That's right, Misha's son or nobody. That's the vital point. Please take care to see that it's clear. That misbehaving lady.
You just leave it all to me and have some witnesses ready.
Just wait a moment.
Well,
add this to all the rest. Please write this as well, that if Mashenka marries Mika's son, any money her father may owe to Mika shall be forgone, and that Mashenka will be the dowry. That makes it fair and square to me.
Yes, yes, everything shall be as you have said.
A better bargain, then you'll find it's time that you'll
retrieve it.
And that's the end of Act Two of Smetana's opera, The Bartered Bride, which we're broadcasting from the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. Act Three will follow after an interval of about 17 minutes. Third program. We return now to the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden, to hear the last act of Smetana's opera, The Bartered Bride. Vasek, alone on the village green, is pondering over the information given him by the charming girl he met at the inn. Is disturbed by the noisy arrival of a band of strolling players, formally introduced by their manager. Vasek is enthralled by their opening dance, and more particularly by one graceful gypsy dancer named Esmeralda. The manager now hears that one of his actors, the one who usually plays the part of a bear, has been at the inn drinking and is now unable to stand up. And he suggests that Vasek should take his place, and that Esmeralda should become his instructress. Left alone to consider their proposal, Vasek is again interrupted this time by his parents, Hata and Toby Micha, with the marriage broker, Ketzel. They try to persuade Vasek to sign the marriage contract, but he flatly refuses. By now, he's convinced that Majenka might try to poison him, and he runs off, terrified. Then Majenka approaches, followed by her parents. She cannot believe that Yannick has agreed to give her up, until Ketzel shows her the document, and even then she says she would rather live to be an old maid than marry Vasek. At this point, Vasek himself rejoins them and immediately recognizes the girl he met at the inn. When he learns that she is Majenka, he's delighted and quite willing to marry her. But Majenka refuses to make up her mind, and they leave her alone to think about it. She still finds it difficult to accept the evidence of Yannick's betrayal. But when Yannick himself comes in happily and behaves as though nothing at all were wrong, she refuses to listen to him and merely asks him point blank whether or not he had agreed to sell her love for money. He has to say yes, and she's so angry that she will not even allow him to explain himself. Ketzel brings back the marriage contract, which she now agrees to sign, and Yannick's only action is to check whether the clause insisting that she shall marry the son of Toby Micha has been included. The villagers crowd back onto the green, anxious to hear Majenka's decision. Among them is Toby Micha, who at once recognizes Yannick as his long-lost son from his first marriage. And now everything becomes clear, because Yannick is legally in a position to marry Majenka. His parents accept the situation with bad grace. But when Vasek rushes up dressed in a bearskin, they realize that Yannick would be a far better match for Majenka, and so they give the lovers their blessing. Now here's the cast for Act 3 in order of singing. Vasek, Kenneth MacDonald, the manager of a troupe of strolling players, Robert Bowman, Esmeralda, a dancer, Elizabeth Robson, an Indian, Eric Garrett, Hata, Elizabeth Bainbridge, Ketzel, Michael Langdon, Toby Micha, Ottokar Kraus, Majenka, Lorna Haywood, Krushina, Napoleon Bisson, Ludmilla, Maureen Guy, and Yannick, Andre Terp. With the Covent Garden Chorus, Chorus Master Douglas Robinson, and the Covent Garden Orchestra led by George Hallam, conducted by Yaroslav Kromholtz.
Thank you.
to see you dance the can-can.
Mr. Manager, things in an awful mess. Down at the inn, Bill has got drunk again. Drunk as a lord, and he'll never pull himself together. Not in time, at least, to get into the Bear's Inn.
What's this? He will mess up the show. How can we do without the bear? People come in mice to see the bear dance. Good God, man, this is a hell of a mess. Isn't there someone suitable, some country bumpkin, to put in his place?
Look, we've been everywhere, but all the villagers sniggered, said it was none of their business. Where on earth we find a man large enough to fill up the bear skin where it's me? Soon all the audience will be here, and there's no time to waste. I can't think what to do.
Just allow that here a moment.
Oh, there's a girl I can fall for. I quite lost my heart to her. How I wish that she was my girl. She's a darling, and I'm not afraid of her.
Who cares?
He's the very chap for the job. He'll fit the skin just as though he's been made for it.
Don't set the scenery and call the cast. I have a woman with him and fix it.
You shall dance it with me.
Ba, 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 ba.
at all.
Son, do we now must fight?
Then, after,
son, do we now must fight?
looking for your money. Wait till the contract is quite ready, then we'll settle up everything. Son.
But it's understood that she cannot marry anyone except the son of Mika. Those were my terms.
Yes, that is right. Yes, that's the arrangement.
Oh, could you be so bad?
Oh, working overseas. Defending the hostage and
blood. Out of the army now for many a day. All that is done, and now I'm here to prove that I am poor Bernicia's eldest son.
We leave you for to live on this. That is the thing we must discuss.
Oh, no, I don't want ever more. I'm independent of you all. But you and I, we never agree. I only want to look now. I am your mother's first born son.
Thank goodness you're no son of mine.
No matter, it can't be denied. I need a son, and there's the deed. Now come, let's come, disagree.
Look in, look in, the bears are blue!
That's the end of Smetana's opera, The Bartered Bride, broadcast tonight from the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. This was the cast. Mazhenka, Lorna Haywood. Yenik, Andre Turk. Ketzel, Michael Langdon. Vashek, Kenneth MacDonald. Ludmila, Maureen Guy. Prushina, Napoleon Bisson. Harta, Elizabeth Bainbridge. Toby Micha, Ottica Krauss. Esmeralda, Elizabeth Robson. The manager, Robert Bowman, and an Indian, Eric Garrett. With the Covent Garden Chorus, Chorus Master Douglas Robinson, and the Covent Garden Orchestra, led tonight by George Hallam. The opera was conducted by Jaroslav Kromholtz and produced by Hanush Tyne. The introductory narrations were written by John McCulloch.
The time is now 25 minutes to 11. We're sorry that our next program is starting rather later than advertised, owing to